speaking about agents of change, of course, some have hailed Mr. Kejriwal as perhaps an agent of change, but he's of course, thanks to his what we have seen the last 6 months, a number of people have called them anarchists, some have termed them populists, some call them good for nothing but for their theatrics. So a number of words being thrown around, but of course it's difficult to question that he has shifted the discourse, at least the political discourse on the issue of corruption. So when you look at this political upstart, what are your expectations when you look at 2014?
Look, first of all, one must congratulate Mr. Anna Hazare. He started the movement, but between starting a movement and being able to deliver it, these are miles apart. The fact that Anna Hazare and Mr. Kejriwal brought the question of corruption as a talking point amongst the people is a great achievement. Now, going from there to be able to rule can be very painful. And you have to hope that Mr. Kejriwal will learn from this process how to change himself from a person who created something and could not deliver it in administration, and the others, that to the country, the issue which Mr. Kejriwal brought up is a very important question. Let's attend to it, otherwise we are going to die.
But you don't have faith in them, confidence in them to actually go the whole hog from talking about it to delivering?
It very rarely happens. People, after all, who are instruments in any movement, they don't see the results. How long Mahatma Gandhi last after he got us the freedom?
Fair enough. So on to, of course, the broader question about economy. That has, of course, as per you, been one of the reasons, one of the factors that has, which will be a decisive factor. When we look at the macroeconomic indicators, on one hand, we have the rupee, which is definitely doing better now, off the lows of October of 2013. The CAD, some extraordinary measures, but we have seen that improving. But on the other side, we also have high inflation, high consumer inflation. We also have issues regarding debt to GDP, etc. When you look at these indicators, how do you see the coming few months?
It's a very good question. I mean, this, we are really now getting to the question of economy, not the politics. But first of all, we need to make India competitive. It's not as competitive as we like to think. We should not worry too much about the value of the rupee. We should worry, number one, that inflation must come down because you are hurting the poor man. You are almost destroying the poor man even more in this country by that inflation. So interest rates, much though I don't like high interest rate, but what other option a governor has of the Bank of Reserve Bank to reduce the inflation? As far as the value of the rupee, personally, if I was running the economy, I wouldn't worry that too much. Only by bringing the rupee down, we would be able to compete. And at the moment, don't forget, the world is busy in trying to keep their currencies down. US dollar, I am sure, is being kept low. Euro is being kept low. Japanese have been trying to keep the Japanese low, yen low, because they want to be competitive. And that is what we should worry about in India. We shouldn't worry too much about the rupee. It will get strengthened if we make the country competitive. Let's provide jobs to the people. Let's produce more. We are capable of producing far more. We should be suppliers to the world.
So, given that you are optimistic, may I also ask you if you're looking to perhaps invest in India, looking at opportunities here?
Oh, we are. I mean, without any question, my son, who is the chief executive of the company, he comes every 6 weeks. I mean, I am an old man, but and we have invested and we continue to invest more money. I have a lot of hopes for India. It's, and we have made a lot of improvements in the way we run our works.
Mm-hmm.
You don't hear too much about it because we are 100%
mm-hmm.
one shareholder owning the company. But we have built 30 plants in the last 12 years in India, all over India. And I am very optimistic about India on the longer term. I would like to be optimistic on the shorter term, mm-hmm. but that unfortunately is delayed too much because of what is happening in the country.
So can you give us a sense of the scope of investments that you have made or are looking at in the, say, next 5 years?
Let me put it this way. The equity which I have put in and the money which I have put in, if you take the ratio of the borrowings which I have against it,
mm-hmm.
perhaps is one of the lowest in this country.
That's an interesting way of putting it.
That showed my faith.
So just this last question here, this one has got to do with quantitative easing, easy money.
Yeah.
That has been one heated subject of debate the world over. And more recently, we've seen Governor Rajan, of course, bring up the issue, to which we saw a rebuttal by Mr. Yeah. Ben Bernanke yeah. as well. Governor, we all know their concerns. Governor Rajan feels that we're looking at greater inflation, greater volatility. Ben Bernanke believes that a faster growing U.S., a better U.S. is what's best for the world economy. So when you look at this debate here, on which side of the world do you stand?
I am a great admirer of Mr. Rajan, but I think the policy of the central banks will have to be limited to the governors of those banks instead of from one country to the other.
Mm.
As I said already, that United States is trying to keep the dollar down,
mm-hmm.
in my view.
Mm-hmm.
I think euro is the right to get down because they want to be competitive.
Mm-hmm.
So that's my view.
But do you see emerging markets such as India having gained more or lost more as a part of this entire exercise of easy money?
Personally, I wouldn't worry about this.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the bureaus, as I said, I have publicly praised Mr. Raghurajan's action. I don't know him.
Mm-hmm.
However, I think we have to live, but the world wants to decide the policy. We cannot decide policy of other countries,
mm-hmm.
nor I like other countries to tell me what India should do.
Mm-hmm.
I want the Indian people to tell India what they should do. And that's what democracy is all about.
Right, sir. Right, sir. That I think sums it up for us. Thank you so much for joining
us
and sharing
much.
Your time and perspective with us, sir.
Thank
Lovely
you so
having
much.
You, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.